Hey guys, I'm going back into some classic watercolor painting here. I'm making this because there is a show coming up that is themed for gates. These shows are kind of funny because they just take an object or something and make that the theme. It's always kind of hard to come up with something that fits a theme, but the only gate that means anything to me is this one. I have a photo of it. It is a gate that my grandpa made. I'm pretty sure. It looks extremely homemade, so I'm assuming that he made it. It's located at where they used to live, which was very much a second home for me when I was a tiny child. I did paint this gate before, and it is a representation of this place that I used to love being. Of course, it's easy to say that because I was only ever at their house during, you know, summer vacation and on weekends and things. So, you know, when you don't have to do school or any unpleasant things, these places can become very much like a utopia, especially when you're a kid and you're looking back on it. So that was what the first painting was about, and this one is sort of like a sequel. Behind this gate is the utopia, and I'm painting a bunch of flowers as a background before I put the gate in. I'm using some paper tole effects on this painting as usual, so I'm going background first, and then I will start to paint the details on a different piece of paper to cut out and glue on top of it. And so what you will see at the end is a beautiful garden with a rickety gate in front of it and a huge lock on the gate and arrows shooting at it. Now, arrows could like mean a lot of things to a lot of people. To me, it's just a literal sort of image. I mean, this makes reference to a time in my life. I was really young, like 7 or something. And, you know, random regular family events happened that split the family up, and it was so dramatic that, you know, my grandparents and my parents conspired to make me believe that I was no longer welcome in this utopia of mine. I really like stewed on this memory for a very long time, and it was like such a source of anger. But I'm making this painting because the theme is a gate, and so this is the only gate that I can think of doing. Now, adding arrows is kind of tricky, especially when it's cut out because arrows are so narrow and stuff. I'm kind of surprised that I was able to pull that off, but it was kind of unnecessary. But I wanted them to be there because it's sort of like it's the only other memory I can think of that is related to a gate, and that is I was walking home from school. This is a childhood story. Actually, it was in high school. I was walking home from high school, and I was just about to turn around the corner and walk toward my backyard. As I got closer to the corner, I see this arrow whip by me. It was still like 10 feet away or something like that. And it went soaring down the street, like half a block down the road. It turns out that my stepdad was practicing with his crossbow and had put a target right on the gate and missed, and so it shot right through the fence. Being an obedient child, I ran after it because I thought, oh no, it's gonna blow out someone's car tire or something. It was only much, much later that I realized that if I had been like 10 seconds early home from school, I would have gotten an arrow literally like in the chest. And that's probably the only reason why I remember it, and so that's the only other connotation to a gate that I have. And so I decided to combine these two memories together and have the arrows hitting the gate. You could even say that it's a metaphor for not only closing the door on something you once loved, but also being really, really aggressive with it, really persistent. Although the gate is rickety and it doesn't seem to be blocked off on one side, and there's a wall you can climb over, so I guess you could say that you could also just always go back whenever.